My name is Sujata Toda, and on behalf of Chinmaya Mission Alpharetta Swaranjali team, I am honored to welcome all of you to this evening's Divine Music Concert by Sangeetkar, Group of Atlanta. Chinmaya Swaranjali is the musical wing of Chinmaya Mission dedicated to exploring the mystical world of Indian classical and devotional music and to discovering its hidden joys. Chinmaya Mission Alpharetta Swaranjali has taken up this project to present local artists and to promote interest in both Hindustani and Carnatic music. Swaranjali team has organized several concerts each month this year in our beautiful Chinmaya Mission Ashram in the presence of Mandir's main deity Sundar Krishna. Sangeetkar means music makers. Sangeetkar is a group of instrumental musicians from the Indian subcontinent presenting North Indian classical compositions and folk tunes. Formed in 1982 in Atlanta, Sangeetkar has performed in art and music festivals, banquets, fundraisers, Indian and other community special events throughout the southeastern United States, as in Georgia, Florida, North Carolina, and Tennessee. Now let me introduce tonight's artists. On violin is Shri Amitava Singh from Calcutta. He learned violin from masters from South and North India and also plays a number of other instruments. He trained under late Professor Robin Ghosh, renowned North Indian classical violinist and teacher, and a disciple of late Ustad Alauddin Khan of Meher Gharana. In Atlanta, Amitava studied Western violin techniques at Emory University, where he has completed his MBA as well. He has performed and composed music in a variety of styles and wrote songs that were later recorded by renowned singer Suresh Varkar. He has accompanied visiting Indian classical and semi-classical vocalists in various cities in the United States on harmonium, keyboard, violin, or tabla. On sitar is M.H. Akmo. Who comes from Brahmanbaria, Bangladesh. Inspired by his mother, Akmal began preliminary training at home under Ustad Israel Mia. He then studied with well-known sarod player Ustad Afzalur Rahman, a disciple of the famous maestro late Ustad Ali Akbar Khan at Aladdin Sangeet Angan Institute of Music. Akmal won numerous awards in music competitions in Bangladesh and performed regularly on Radio Bangladesh. He has performed extensively in and out of Atlanta. In 2017, he received a Lifetime Achievement Award for promoting Bengali culture in Atlanta from Bangladeshi organization Bangla Dhara. On tabla is Dr. Shekhar Pendalwar. He has been a part of Sangeetkar Group for the past several years. Music is his passion. He started learning tabla early in his childhood under the guidance of renowned maestros in India. Shekhar is versatile in accompanying classical, film music, ghazal, fusion music, etc. He has given solo and group performances in and out of Atlanta area. He has accompanied many noted artists from India. Dr. Shekhar was past president of the Indian Classical Music Society of Greater Atlanta. Besides his profession, Shekhar is very active in promoting Indian classical music in the community. Now, before we begin the program, some house rules. Please turn off your cell phones and remember at the end of the program, you will have the opportunity to meet the artists during snack and tea time. Please sit back and enjoy the music. Now, with a round of applause, let us welcome today's artists with a heartfelt gratitude for honoring our invitation to perform.
Thank you all very much for coming in this weather, and a big thank you to the organizers, Swaranjali Group of Chinmaya Mission Alpharetta, for inviting us to perform today. Indian music, that is classical Indian music, traces its roots to sacred chants and hymns used in the worship of various deities. South Indian or Carnatic music is mainly composed with devotional lyrics, whereas North Indian or Hindustani music because of the influence of other cultures such as Persian, Mughal and other now Middle East nations, this has evolved into a more diverse lyrical continent. Today we will present North Indian instrumental music based on ragas and dhuns. Dhuns are short melodies improvised on folk tunes or semi-classical forms like thumris. Now these are devoid of lyrics, so you may associate them freely with whatever mood the music creates in you, including divine worship. Hence the program Divya Dhun on divine melodies. However, we will not be explicitly restricting ourselves to playing bhajans or devotional songs. We may play a few lines of them here and there, mixed in our dhuns. Now ragas, as many of you know, are melodic structures that express a certain mood or emotion, and many are associated with seasons of the year or time of day in Hindustani music. So we will present four or five different ragas considered to be associated with various times of the day and interspersed with shorter folk tune dhuns or semi-classical pieces. We begin with Raga Bhim Palasa, a late afternoon raga fit for this hour, usually sung between 2 to 4 p.m. These ragas are classified according to different prahars of the day, which are like 3-hour segments of time. So we play in the traditional form of alap, which is introduction with no rhythm, then a madhyalaya gat or medium tempo composition in dhimtal cycle of 16 beats, and followed by a drut or fast composition ending with chhala. This is the climax played on the sitar in chikari strings. Example, the chhala. So that these chikari strings are the open strings tuned to the tonic of the note, and is played usually at the end of a composition. Now to introduce the notes or patterns of notes in the ragas, we'll play just a couple of lines from a famous Hindi or Bollywood song that you might know, which were composed in the era where these were ragas. So Bhim Palasi is represented by Ye Zindagi Usi Ki Hai, a song from 1953 movie Anarkali, sung by Lata Mangeshkar, composed by C. Ramachandra. This is how it goes. Play the actual raga in our rendition of Bhim Palasi.